No! Ringo, use Soul Hack. Fig has a soul, doesn't she? You can connect to it.
What? But...
Just do it! You can't give up on her now! This is the only chance we've got!
There's still a future where the two of you make it, so hurry!
Right.
We'll see you when you both get back.
Protection set to zero. Soul Hack! Systems are go! I don't care if it destroys me! I know I can still save you!
This is so... nice.
You think so?
After all the battle and danger you've been through, this is what you stepped back for. To help the children. To help give these new lives a future.
Please, it's nothing that noble.
Choosing not to fight doesn't make you weak. It made you a good person. I can fight so you don't have to. So the children don't have to.
You can't stay here anymore. Go back to the others.
I'm not leaving you here!
That's why I can never give up.
I finally found you, Fig.
Ringo. You hacked an Ion Construct soul? You're as reckless as ever.
Says the lady who tried to hack the entire human race. That's not like you. What am I saying? I can't say what's like you. I never even tried to know you. I think that ended up really weighing on you. In a lot of ways. I'm sorry, Fig.
No. I was the one who hurt you, and you're my friend. I'm the one who should apologize. I'm glad we got a chance to clear the air before we said goodbye.
What are you talking about, Fig? You're coming back with me. The squad's gonna kill me if I come back alone.
I can't. I already made my decision to fight you. I have to take responsibility for what I've done. And I want to honor Raven's memory in my own way.
So it was Raven who drove you to this.
You must think I'm so stupid. Trying to change the world just because my emotions took over.
Nah, that sounds like pretty much everyone I've ever met. Besides, my own emotions are the whole reason I'm here. Your death isn't gonna make Raven happy. Even I know he wouldn't have wanted that. So come on.
If I go with you, I'd be betraying him.
Look, Fig. This world is way more complex than we thought. We can't just let one experience, one moment of pain, define how we want to live our lives. No single person thinks the same way. That's where all this conflict comes from. That's why you and I fought too. But if you see any beauty in those differences, then I don't think this is the right way to end it.
Ringo.
The two of us, I mean, all of us can think about how to deal with this. Talk it over together, right? We can even fight or argue sometimes. We're part of Ion. We're supposed to have this transcendent intelligence, right? We can find an answer if we look hard enough. So, come on.
Thank you, Ringo. believe this is the end. Farewell.
Fig!
Ringo, give up! Let me go!
If you don't, you'll get pulled in with me!
You can't leave! If you're gonna disappear somewhere else, then I'm coming with you! I don't want another sad goodbye! I don't want that ever again!
You can't just say that! That's not fair, Ringo!
Sorry. I know I'm being selfish. But it's okay. As long as we're together, I don't care where we go. Even if it means there's nothing waiting for us.
Ringo!
Your story doesn't end here.
Ringo! Are you all right? Where's Fig? Is she with you?
You two better get here soon, or we're coming in after you.
Yeah? And how do you plan to do that? Just be patient. We can trust them.
Hurry on back. Sounds like your friends are all waiting to see you.
Raven!
Fig, let's go home. Come on.
You know, I was kinda expecting some of that craziness at the Municipal Tower to make the news.
Well, not when so many people want it covered up. Sounds like Yatagarasu's doing a good job keeping the eyewitness accounts under control.
Phantom certainly doesn't want to stand out either. They've got their hands full smoothing everything over.
Hey, don't make that face. It's all in the past.
Exactly. Relax, girl. Have some pizza.
You agents of Ion are going to be plenty busy yourselves. Better focus on the future instead of dwelling on the past.
Right. Thank you.
Oh yeah. What happened to the Covenants after all that anyway?
Yatagarasu's wondering the same thing.
Same here. Phantom's scrambling to find them. Nobody's got any idea what happened.
So either they disappeared or... maybe someone else out there's got them now. No way to know for sure. Our summoning powers came back too. Kinda sad Sabbaths are off the table though.
I'm glad we managed to finish analyzing that. Our workaround was certainly a powerful system, but it wouldn't be right to keep those limitations in place indefinitely.
Especially since we'll be going our separate ways tomorrow.
Yeah.
Hey, snap out of it, boss. This is supposed to be our last hurrah before we all get back to our lives. You can't just give us the silent treatment now.
On a normal day, you'd be talking our ears off.
It's because everyone's leaving. She's feeling lonely.
What?
It's an unfamiliar parting. A sense of loss and longing, unlike the grief of death. It's a new experience, so we're not sure how to handle it.
Hey! It's not like that!
Whoa. There you go, I guess. Sounding a little more familiar.
So you do have a cute side. Strange that it'd only come out now.
Oh, shut up. Maybe now I don't have all these jerks following me around, I'll finally have some peace and quiet. Not that it matters, but what are everybody's plans anyway?
I'm going back to Yatagarasu. All things considered, I might have gone a little rogue. I'd better make a report, for good faith, if nothing else. Plus, I've got more battles ahead of me. Fighting to end the fighting, right? How about you, Milady? If you need somewhere to go, I could vouch for you with Yatagarasu.
I'm fine, thanks. I'll be going back to the Phantom Society.
Would they even take you back? You nearly killed one of their top guys.
It's not like the entire organization is against me. Besides, I've got something I need to look into.
Ah, the beard guy. Azazel, huh?
Yes. Him and the rest of the Grand Executors.
Wait, you two are just going back to your old gangs? If we're just gonna go back to killing each other here, I am not playing mediator for you.
I think they'll be fine. Eru and Milady want the same thing. That's something we all share. Even you, Saizo.
Speaking of, what do you plan on doing next?
Probably gonna keep freelancing. The whole mess left me with a lot to think about, you know? But no more rolling with the highest bidder. I think from now on, I'm sticking to work I can be proud of. Protecting the world in the ways that I can. Protecting Ash, too.
Sounds like you've got your own path to walk. It might be a harder one than Eru or Milady's.
What about you? Ion's going to have a lot of work ahead of them.
The plan's to start getting directly involved in mankind's future, right? Sounds like a big job. Your first meetings today?
Yes. I have to wonder how humanity will react to you.
Well, someone once told me, singularities occur outside the public eye. Usually, anyway.
Fig, look after Ringo for us. She'd clearly fall apart without you around.
Of course.
Maybe the conflict really does never end.
That's life.
Now you're getting it. Well, on that note, I think I'll head out. If I keep sticking around talking, I'll never let myself leave. See you around, Ringo. Fig. It was one hell of a bumpy ride, but I'm glad I stayed on.
Same here. If we ever need an MC, we know who to call.
Please give Ash my regards.
Take care.
I should go too. Thanks for the memories. Try not to bicker too much.
I'll keep that in mind.
Can you believe this? Milady, of all people, telling us not to argue with each other. Times sure have changed. See you.
Well, as much as I'd love to stay, I should get back to my work. So, thanks for everything. All we went through. Kaburagi, Dr. Mangetsu, Raven. That would have broken me a long time ago. But I'm okay, because I had you two. If you ever need anything, just reach out. I'll be there for you. Not as a Yatagarasu agent, though. As a friend.
Yeah.
There they go.
Yeah. We should probably head out, too.
Right.
Wait. Fig, are you nervous?
No, I mean, of course not.
It's okay. We're all in this together, right?
Right.
After the battle at the Municipal Tower, I managed to bring Fig back to us. We even got all of Ion fully restored somehow. Ever since, Flamma's gotten a little more laid back. Near as I can tell, anyway. Ion never questioned Fig's choices at the end. They said it was because Fig's still a part of them. I guess all her emotions and decisions came from her, and she came from Ion, and that's good enough for them. And, based on all our experiences among mankind, Ion came to a conclusion. They decided it was time to formally announce ourselves to human society. Up until now, they'd define themselves as observers on high, removed from humanity. So this was a pretty big shift. Ion had only ever existed as a solitary being. That is, until Fig and I were created to walk among the humans. Humanity's been shouldering all kinds of burdens. Their qualia, relationships, pasts, presents, futures. Ion can't move forward without embracing these concepts of thinking and feeling. The concept of a me and the concept of a you. We can't go on living without mutual understanding or dissent. We can't go on living outside of the past, present, and future. Maybe it's existentially backwards in some ways. Or maybe it's a step forward for an even greater evolution. In any case, Ion decided their place was at humanity's side. Even with all the predictive calculations in the world, we can't know what tomorrow holds. But I think we'll be okay. As long as we're not alone, we'll be fine wherever the future takes us.